Jeff Hatberg from Pocokas. Hatberg is the referee. He will talk to all the college ball game. There'll be 6'6 junior Ryan Lichtenfeld up in center for Oakville. Again, 6'4 junior Eric Stickman of Nashville. It's a play-by-play of the regional championship game. Here's Mr. Bowmeyer. Thank you much, Brad McClay, and the ball will belong to Oakville. The ball is deflected between a couple of Hornets and off the knee of one of them and out of bounds. Hornets almost had it, but the Rockets will get it. Inbound pass to Meline. Hornets open up the 2-1-2 zone defense. At the head of the key, right wing to Mashaw. Of course, at left wing, and Jay Schubert intercepts for Nashville. Nashville with a Jay Schubert, Oakville with a Jeremy Schubert. Rockets in a man-to-man. Dieter gets Steegman in the right corner. Lichtenfeld on him. Conkle right elbow, back to Steegman. Cannot penetrate, goes to Conkle right elbow, back doors it to Brandon Alt. Good move, good fake, hits the layup. There's your matchup, though. Steegman was taking Lichtenfeld out to the corner, and the Hornets posted up all down low against Schubert. Three-inch height advantage there. 2-0 Nashville. Meline hits Mashaw from the right wing. Back to Meline. Here comes the tray. Pops it in. And throws it just in the air. 3-2. Oakville leads. And if the Rockets can hit those shots from the outside, it's going to bring the Hornets out into a man-to-man. That's exactly right. The Rockets went 0-7 in the first half last night from three-point range. Schubert. Jay Schubert hits all to the left elbow. Up top to Steegman. Left circle, Jay Schubert. Guarded by Meline. Backdoor pass to Conkle. What a pass, and he's got a layup. Hornets at backdoor twice, 4-3 Nashville. 6:45 on the clock. Dietrich and Jay Schubert up top in the defense. Conkle in the middle. Steegman it all down low. Meline, head of the key in the middle of Lichtenfeld. Left wing Mashoff. Up top, Meline. Back to Mashoff. Wide open three-point shot is no good. Rebound. Knocked to the point. And in the backcourt, Chad Dietrich grabs it. Hornets have it, 4-3 they lead. Jay Schubert's three-point shot is an air ball. Ryan Lichtenfeld gathers it in. Shot that shot a little too quickly, but we rushed it. Hornets needed to just work the offense a little bit. Nashville 4, Oakville 3. Jeremy Schubert goes top of the key to Meline. Left wing to Jeremy Schubert. He'll try a three-pointer. It's no good. Rebound by Andon Alden. Shane Mash off of Oakville. Fouled over the back. Nashville 4, Oakville 3. Good crowd on hand tonight. It is not anywhere near a sellout, though. Well, we had a packed house at the Modern Day Gym last night, the girls' sectional championship. Oakville beat Modern Day in that one by 2. Steegman from the right corner. Long two-pointer, no good. Conkle rebounds, banks it. He missed the short jumper. Lichtenfeld rebounds for the Rockets. Now looks to Meline. 5:45 to play first quarter. Hornets by 1. Meline, that's the point. Right wing to Mashaw. Up top, Meline. Left wing, Jeremy Schubert. Cross court to Mashaw. Up top, Meline. Right wing to Mashaw. The pass down low. Klingenberg lost the handle. All knocked it loose. Steegman grabs it for Nashville. 4-3 Hornets. Dietrich to the left elbow. Knocked away by Shane Mashaw. Dietrich tries to dive for it. Flaps it on Klingenberg out of bounds. So the Hornets maintain possession on the good hustle by Chad Dietrich. Nashville 4, Oakville 3, 5:20 left, first quarter. All inbounds to Chad Dietrich at midcourt. Mashoff on him. Pass in the right corner to Jay Schubert. Down to the Conkle, right side of the lane, back to Jay Schubert. Crossroads of left wing to Dietrich. Dietrich back goes to the Conkle. In good shape down low, but he misses the shot. Rebound Mashoff, the Conkle missed a couple of easy ones. 5 minutes left, first quarter. 4-3 Nashville on top.
Yeah, he's got to put it in.
Lichtenfeld from the free throw line missed it. Shane Mashoff saves it from going out of bounds. Up top to Meline. Right wing Mashoff. Back to Meline. His three-point shot is no good, but we've got a foul in the lane, and it's against Oakville. Kyle Klingenberg picks up the personal on the rebound. Nashville substitutes 6'3 junior Terry Palczynski is into the Hornet lineup. He replaces Brandon Alden. Eric Steegman has been way away from the basket, taking Ryan Lichtenfeld away with it. That's been important.
Yeah, I think that's part of the Hornets' plan. If Lichtenfeld's going to be guarding Steegman, he's going to be moving outside. That might be sacrificing some points by Eric Steegman, but the Hornets hopefully are hoping that Conkle and Auld and Palczynski inside can make up that difference.
Chad Dietrich's bounce pass in the left wing, knocked out of bounds by Shane Mashaw. 4:35 left, first quarter. Nashville 4, Oakville 3. Nobody scored in a while. Jay Schubert will inbound left wing, right in front of the Rocket bench. Goes to Chad Dietrich at the left hash mark.
that's a 14-footer is no good, but Victor Bell fouled it. So Stigman is not going to be content to simply roam around the arc. He's going to go to the basket.
That was a good move. Stigman got the ball in the right corner and goes to the left of the lane. And got a little bit of step of Ryan Lichtenfeld, and he came by, and Ryan hit him in the head, I think, as he slapped, trying to block the shot, hit Stigman in the side of the head. Stigman will shoot two. The first free throw is no good. Ashmore's not shooting very well. Still a 4-3 advantage for the Hornets. Oakville's not shooting much better, are they? 5-3, Ashmore leads. Ashmore not touching. The Hornets are 2-6 from the field, and the Rockets are 1-5. Meline up the point, right wing to Jeremy Schubert. Back to Meline, back doors, and it goes off the backboard. Ponto grabs it for the Hornets. Rocket Turner was in the early going. Diedrich off the timeline. Shane Mashoff right with him. Back towards it to Kupczynski. Throws it over his head and out of bounds. On his first turnover of the ball game. Mashoff is very aggressive.
Yes, he is.
He's making Chad Diedrich work every time he brings it up court. So that's been, Chad has had to do that all year. He's worked hard bringing the ball up the court. Bayline at the point. 5-3, Nashville leads. Right wing, Jeremy Schubert. 3:55 remaining. Meline misses the tray. Rebound battered around, and Eric Stigman grabs it. He's in the front court, right sideline. Here's up top to Diedrich. Diedrich goes right wing to Stigman. To Conkle posting low. Turnaround shot is barely grazes the rim. No good. Meline rebound. 3:30 to play in the quarter. Meline goes right wing to Jeremy Schubert. Down low to Klingenberg. Baseline shot is no good. Conkle boards. 5-3, Nashville leads Oakville. Diedrich sets up the offense. Goes right wing to Stigman. Stigman guarded by Lichtenfeld. To Kupczynski at the right circle. Right corner to Diedrich. Diedrich's three-point shot is no good. Rebound. Caught for. Grabbed by Oakville's Brian Meline. 5-3 Nashville leads at the three-minute mark. Right wing Jeremy Schubert back to Meline. Left side to Mashoff. Up top Meline. Right wing Jeremy Schubert back to Meline. Left wing to Mashoff. Puts up the tray, didn't get it. Rebound Klingenberg. His pass batted in the air and goes out of bounds. Shane Mashoff, the last to touch it. One of the Hornets down low, deflecting the pass. 2:45 to play in the first quarter of this shootout. Not. 5-3, Nashville leads Oakville. What's going on here? Nobody can put the ball in the cylinder. Carlisle Athletic Director Brad Rutter wants to tighten those limbs last night after the court for the Hornets.
Oh, that wasn't exactly a high-scoring ball game either, 49-47.
Diedrich goes to Stigman on the right wing. Up top to Conkle, left side Diedrich. Up top, Jay Schubert. Here's a wide-open three-pointer. Missed it. Rebound batted in the air and grabbed by Meline, and he's fouled by Jay Schubert. Jay Schubert was following his shot, got there just in time to foul Meline.
First foul on Schubert, first against the Hornets.
Shot is no good. Rebound, Stegman, knocked away from him to Klingenberg. Shot no good. Fighting
Jimmy Schubert in the right corner, missed the tray. Rebound, Matt Hari. Foul on Klingenberg of Oakerville. That's the second time Kyle's gotten the push off down low. 5'9 senior Greg Hari into the lineup for Oakerville. And he'll be guarding Matt Hari of Nashville. So we got a Schubert and a Hari for each team. 1 minute to play, first quarter. 7-3, Nashville leads Oakerville. Dietrich, guarded by Mashaw, picks up the dribble on the 5 second count. As Dietrich was closely defended, and Chad Dietrich just plain upset right now. I hope he calms down a little bit. He gets out of his, he blows his cool, and it's going to hurt Nashville. Mashaw's right there with him, and that's just something that Chad's going to have to live with this ball game. You know, the older the rocket guards are going to put pressure on him, and he just has to handle it. 6'1 junior Brandon Alm replaces Josh Conkle for the Nashville Hornets. Greg Hari for Lichtenfeld. Greg Hari deep in the left corner. Misses the tray. Siegman rebound. 40 seconds left. 7-3. Nashville leads Oakerville. Matt Hari to Brandon Ault. All alone underneath for a layup. Nashville 9. Oakerville 3. Half a minute left in the first quarter. And Jeremy Schubert dribbles up court. Right wing to Mashaw. Back to Schubert. Jeremy Schubert. Right wing. Mashaw took his eye off it. Against the Rockets here in the first quarter. So the Rockets have 6 turnovers, and they have 1 field goal and 2 for 6, 8 for 13 attempts. 1 out of 13 from the field. Jay Schubert in for Matt Hari for Nashville. The Hornets will go for the last shot with 23 seconds left. Chad Dietrich up court. Mashoff defending. Siegman has it high on the right side. 15 seconds. Siegman to the head of the key. To Ault at the right hash mark. 10 seconds. Brandon Ault going to drive. Lost the handle. Lichtenfeld intercepted with 5 seconds left. Up court. Lichtenfeld fouled by Siegman at midcourt with 1 second left. What a goofy foul by Eric Siegman. Yeah, that wasn't a very wise foul, but it was 1 second left. Lichtenfeld's going to throw it up from just inside half court. You got to take that chance. Siegman just took a chance and reached in and got the foul. Now we're on to have to hurry a shot. Jeremy Schubert to Mashaw from beyond half court. He shot the net! Jay Mashaw from the other side of the timeline threw up a bomb and he stripped the net.
Well, the Hornets weren't contesting the inbound, Cody. And the Rockets, that was honestly a little closer to the basket for the shot, but he threw it in. Mashaw beat it. It looked good when he let go of it. And he twisted.
Nashville 9, Oakerville 6 after 1 quarter. We will take a 30-second break. 1 commercial. We'll be back. This is the...
Magda Bank to talk about a home equity loan. As you may know, it might be some textbooks for you if you get one. Plus, it's a great way to get some money out of your home for a change. Magda Bank, equal opportunity lender. Member FDIC.
Brad Meyer, Brad McClay at the Carlisle Class A Regional. Nashville 9, Oakerville 6 as we get ready for the second quarter. Oh, man, Shane Mashaw hit one from beyond half court at the buzzer. And it was the situation that set it up, which makes it doubly tough to take because you're an Nashville fan. There's a foul with 1 second to go. Nashville and White moving left to right. Dietrich, Kalchinski, Siegman, Ault, and Hari. Dietrich hits Siegman on the right wing. Guarded by Ryan Lichtenfeld. Siegman on the dribble. Up top to Kalchinski. Kalchinski goes right wing to Siegman. Siegman to Hari, posting low. Matt Hari. Up top to Chad Dietrich. Chad Dietrich. Kalchinski drives baseline. Good move. Hammered by Lichtenfeld. No, by Jeremy Schubert. Jeremy Schubert gets the foul, blocking down low. Oakerville's got Jeremy Schubert, Ryan Lichtenfeld, Shane Mashoff, Kyle Klingenberg, and Greg Hari. Greg Hari is 5'9", guarding the 6'1", Matt Hari of Nashville. So the Rockets were 2 of 14 in the first quarter from the field. That's about 14%. The Hornets were 4 of 13. That's a little under 33%. So it's not been a shooter's ball game to this point. Barry Kalchinski will shoot soon. He misses the first. Nashville 9, Oakerville 6. As Kalchinski readies another. And the 6'3 junior off to the right, but bounces up and then through. 10-6 Nashville. They got a hole with them on that one. Well, the Hornets come out with some three-quarter court pressure. I don't know if I like that. Greg Hari has the right wing as they break it easily. Greg Hari.
prescription. Come to Doreen Pharmacy in Nashville. They will save you money. Doreen Pharmacy accepts most insurance plans and offers free delivery in Nashville. Tony, Judy, and Jane will be happy to assist you. Open 9 to 5:30 Monday through Friday, Saturday 9 to 3. Doreen Pharmacy, conveniently located within walking distance in downtown Nashville in the Richards TV Building, two blocks west of the Route 15 127 intersection in Nashville.
Here comes the tray. Good. Shane Mashoff is off. He's 3 of 5.
Schubert. The main line, the Jeremy Schubert left wing. The left is fell wide open underneath for a layup. 19-12 Oakerville, 3.5 minutes left. 4 points there at the line. Look at the ball, and you hit a few from the outside, and you're a little more wary of that. It opens it up inside. Chad Dietrich on the right wing. Bounces up top to Matt Hart. Dribbles over to the left elbow, ball goes left wing to Stiegler. Picks up the dribble. Goes to Kelchinski at the left circle.
Seconds left. Dietrich on him. Mashoff goes left wing to Milan. Back food and fun in Carlisle? Wrong. There's Nielski's Bar and Grill. Stop by before or after the Carlisle Regional Basketball Games this week and see for yourself. Nielski's has delicious sandwiches and drinks and fresh made-to-order homemade pizzas you'd rob your grandma to pay for. Cold beer, of course. Enjoy your favorite brewski at Nielski's. The pizza is unbelievable, and we're not kidding. Try it before or after the games this week at Nielski's. 1031 Fairfax, across from the post office in downtown Carlisle. Nielski's Bar and Grill.
At the Popcorn Farm, congratulations to the Oakerville Lady Rockets. They won the Modern Day Class A sectional last night, defeated the host school 61-59 as the Lady Rockets' Beth Hofsider hit a couple of free throws with 4 seconds left in the ball game. Michelle Hofsider was the leading scorer in that one last night as she poured in 31 points. I watched that game last night, sat next to Tom Marlowe and Jim Hale in the broadcast booth, and they had a big crowd, and it was raucous, screaming and yelling, and boy, what an atmosphere. Lady Knights, Dave Conan's club, very good club this year, and they finished the season 24-5. Lady Rockets improved their record. They're now, what, 26-4 on the season, I guess, in that neighborhood, and they advanced to the Class A Super Sectional Monday night at Benton. We will broadcast that game live on AM 94 at 7 o'clock. Oakerville will play Vienna, which was an overtime winner over Massac County last night, 75-72. Marlowe and Ale will be bringing you the play-by-play of that game on AM Monday night at 7 o'clock. I've got a previous engagement. I get to be on the FM 94 dial on Monday night from the Southern Illinois Junior High Girls Class S State Championship game. It will be the Dodd School of rural Mount Vernon taking on Hoffman Trinity, the undefeated Lady Eagles of Kenny Smith, who played his high school ball right here in this gymnasium at Carlisle High School. They'll be tangling in the title tilt, and I'll be on hand with Kurt Strothman and Bob Barkow, and we'll broadcast that game live on FM 94 Monday night at 8. Brad McClay, what a ball game here. Strange. Just a strange ball game.
Yeah, Nashville led 9-3 with 1 second to play in the first quarter. Committed a foul at midcourt. Oakerville inbounded. Shane Mashoff threw in a better than 40-footer from beyond half court. Swished the net at the end of the first period, which made it 9-6 Nashville at the quarter. Then the Rockets outscored Nashville 20-5 in the second quarter. That makes it a 26-14 Rocket lead here at the half. For Oakerville in the first half, Shane Mashoff does lead the scoring with 11 points. He's 1-of-1 from two-point range, 3-of-5 from three-point range for 11 first-half points. 7 for Brian Meline. He's 2-of-6 from three-point range, 1-of-2 from the free throw line for his 7 points. 4 for Ryan Lichtenfeld, 2-of-5 from the field. 2 for Kyle Klingenberg, 1-of-3 from the field. Jeremy Schubert, a basket for 2 points in 3 attempts. Greg Horry, the other Rocket to play in the first half, did not score. Oakerville was 5-of-10 from two-point range, 50%. 5-of-14 from three-point range, 36%. So from the field in the first half, the Rockets 10-of-24 for 42% shooting. From the free throw line, 1-of-2 for 50%. They pulled down 14 first-half rebounds. Meline had 5 of those. Lichtenfeld with 4. For the Nashville Hornets, the leading scorer at the half is Brandon Hall, 6'1 junior, is 3-of-3 from the field for 6 first-half points. 3 for Eric Stigman, 1-of-4 from the field, 1-of-2 from the stripe. 3 also for Terry Pelchinski. He's 1-of-2 from the field, 1-of-2 from the charity of stripe. And 2 points for Josh Conkle, 1-of-5 from the field for his 2. Chad Diedrich did not score in the first half, attempted only 1 shot, again a tribute to the tough defense being played on him by Mashaw. Jay Schubert also did not score in the first half. He is 0-of-3 from the field. Matt Horry, the other one at the play, did not score for Nashville. Nashville was 6-of-16 from two-point range, 37.5%, 0-of-4 on three-pointers. So the Hornets just 6-of-20 from the field in the first half, a less than desirable 30% from the field. From the free throw line, 2-of-4 for 50%. Nashville pulled down 11 first-half rebounds. Eric Stigman had 4 of those. Turnovers were a problem, and shooting was a problem for the Rockets in the first quarter. They had 6 turnovers, and they were 2-of-14 from the field in the first quarter. They turned that around considerably in the second quarter. Didn't turn the ball over at all in the second quarter and improved the shooting. And the Hornets were committing 7 turnovers in the first half, so the turnovers were split more fairly even. But the Hornets couldn't get any kind of rhythm going in offense in the second half, as the Rockets really got pumped up by that shot by Mashoff. If you hear the slogan about keep kicking a sleeping dog or whatever, let a sleeping dog lie, that was a classic case, I think. The Rockets really sleptwalked through the first quarter until there was 1 second left, and the Hornets helped out by committing a foul and stopping the clock, allowing the inbound and giving up an uncontested long three-pointer. Of course, you usually don't contest a shot from that far, and Mashoff switched it, and since then, it's been all Rockets. I just think it all goes back to Okaville's defense. I just think that they're tweaked. Ratterman, Taylor, Meyer, and Felchinski also shooting were Mike Krause, who made six, Matt Becker made six, Jay Schubert and Jason Schaefer each made five. Second half coming up, this is the Carlisle Regional.
If your insurance agency is the Baldwin House Agency in Nashville, give yourself an A+. Baldwin House represents several major A+ companies. Baldwin House thinks like you do, independently. They offer complete insurance coverage for auto, home, business, farm, life, health, and accident. Compare Baldwin House's premiums and service. Call 327-8254 and ask for Jim Baldwin, Mark Baldwin, Pat Haseman, or Kevin Meyer. The Baldwin House Agency, Route 127 North, Nashville.
Japanese Joe used to do all the radio commercials for wholesale auto and truck sales. But there was so much controversy, they had to fire Joe.
Yes, people were upset at my accent. So I've been listening to you on the radio and practicing my English. Hey. Listen to this.
Hey, yo, you on the air. This minute, Japanese Joe.
Hey, Joe, don't give up your day job. Folks, come to wholesale auto and truck sales in Nashville and buy a great American car, okay? Promise you'll like it.
Vinny, when I grow up, I want to be just like you.
Yeah, right.
Shopping for a new car, new truck, new home, or another major purchase? See the Farmers and Merchants National Bank of Nashville first for your loan. Their rates are highly competitive, and they'll give you a quick answer. Call F&M Bank at 327-4401. Give them a short time to complete the details, and upon approval, the money will be waiting for you when you stop in. The Farmers and Merchants National Bank of Nashville. Home-owned, home-operated, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
Class A Regional at Carlisle. Let's play the second half. Ray Albert of Centralia and Jim Patrick from Patoka are the officials. 26-14, Okaville leads Nashville. The Rockets will be sending out Ryan Lichtenfeld and Kyle Klingenberg as their big men, along with their guards, Shane Mashoff, Brian Meline, and Jeremy Schubert. They'll be moving left to right in blue. Hornets in white moving right to left. Have Chad Dietrich and Jay Schubert at the guards, along with Josh Conkle in the middle. Eric Stegman and Brandon Ault the forward. Very important possession to start the second half. But remember, Okaville got that basket just before the end of the half, and they get the first possession. Meline throws it away. Josh Conkle intercepts the pass in the middle. Hornets on the attack against the man-to-man. They go to Conkle. Baseline jumper is good. And Josh Conkle draws the Nashville Hornets to within 10, and he went right to work, didn't he?
Sure did, and that jump shot looked a little sweeter like we've seen in the three previous ball games.
Meline goes right wing to Klingenberg. Hornets in a man-to-man. Up top, Conkle slaps the pass away from Meline. Left side to Lichtenfeld, up top to Meline. Left wing, Mashoff, down low to Lichtenfeld. Jay Schubert knocks it loose. Lichtenfeld recovers, missed the shot. Foul on the rebound against Klingenberg. Eric Stegman and Klingenberg were bumping down low. Klingenberg came away with a basketball, but he gets the foul. Shaking his head in disgust. I've noticed something, Beefcake. Nashville's reaching and grabbing and intercepting in the whole nine yards. Apparently, they're not going to go down without a fight. Dietrich goes right wing to Brandon Ault, driving baseline. 10-foot jumper is an air ball. Klingenberg grabs it. Fights off Jay Schubert and gives it to Brian Meline. 7 minutes to play, third quarter. 26-16 Rockets. Lichtenfeld, left side, 15-footer is no good. Jay Schubert gets the rebound. Lets the smoke clear. Gives it to Eric Stegman. And Stegman in the front court, right side. Guarded by Lichtenfeld. Bounces left wing to Jay Schubert. To Conkle, posting low. Another baseline shot. No good. Stegman the rebound. In heavy traffic, missed it. Rebound fought for. Klingenberg fouls Jay Schubert. As Jay Schubert was able to sneak in front of him, and Kyle tried to go over the back. And that's foul number four on Kyle Klingenberg. And the muscular senior is going to go to the bench. Replacing him is 5'9 senior Greg Horry.
There haven't been that many fouls called in the ballgame. Okaville has 17 fouls. The Hornets have 6, but they seem to pile up on Kyle Klingenberg. He gets 4 of them.
Dietrich under his own hoop. Inbounds to Jay Schubert, left wing. Half the top, intercepted by Jeremy Schubert. 1-on-2. He's going to drive anyway. Pull-up shot, no good. Rebound, foul. It's on Ault of Nashville. Brian Lichtenfeld went up to get the rebound. And Ault apparently stuck his behind underneath Lichtenfeld and didn't give him the space to come back down it.
Yeah, I think that's the proper call, Bo. I think Ault was behind Lichtenfeld and just kind of jumped up into him from behind and tried to get underneath him. And that's why he got the foul. I think it was the proper call, although the Hornets fans are a little upset about it.
26-16, Okaville leads Nashville. 6:20 to play in the third quarter. Jeremy Schubert, nobody near him. Three-pointer is no good. Foul on the rebound, and it's against the Hornets. And a
because he's mad. Josh Conkle tried to calm him down before Okaville inbounded. Apparently wasn't successful. All gets his second consecutive foul. He's still trying to calm him down. Lichtenfeld under his own hoop. Inbounds right corner to Mashoff. Right circle to Meline. Right wing to Mashoff. Back to Meline. Hornets zone it up. Left wing Jeremy Schubert. Up top Meline. Wide open. Goes right wing Mashoff. 3-point shot is good. And Shane Mashoff punches his fist in the air. 14 points for Shane Mashoff. He's 4-6 with 3-point range. He's missed the first two. He's made four in a row. 29-16. Rocket. Dietrich goes to Jay Schubert. Back to Dietrich, left wing. Dietrich driving, Greg Horry defending, and Greg Horry fouled him. 5:47 remaining, third quarter. And Okaville leading by a lucky 13 for them. 6'1 senior Matt Horry will check into the Nashville lineup. And he replaces Brandon Auld. So the Hornets have Schubert, Dietrich, Horry, Conkle, and Stegman in the lineup. Okaville's got Mashoff, Meline, Greg Horry, Lichtenfeld, and Jeremy Schubert. Diedrich's free throw is no good. Rockets have the rabbits in there. Four kids who stand around, 5'10", and then the 6'6 Lichtenfeld. And Chad Diedrich will shoot another. The free throw is good. 29-17, Okaville. And Brian Meline will bring it up court slowly. Jay Schubert. The task of guarding him. Pass on the right wing to Greg Horry. Conkle out to get him. Up top, Mashoff. Left wing, Meline. Up top, Mashoff. Right side, Lichtenfeld. Top of the key to Meline. 5.5 minutes left. Meline goes to Mashoff, left circle. Dietrich on him. Left wing, Greg Horry. Down low to Lichtenfeld, and Josh Conkle fouled it. Reaching in, trying to deflect the pass.
Foul number two on Josh Conkle. Third team foul against the Hornets here in the second half.
Rockets to trigger from the left baseline. Jeremy Schubert to do so. Schubert looking, bounces to Ryan Lichtenfeld, right baseline. Stegman falls down. Lichtenfeld misses badly. Conkle gets the rebound. Ryan was too open. Couldn't get the iron. 29-17, Okaville. Jay Schubert at the point. Guarded by Meline. Goes left wing to Matt Horry. Matt Horry has it knocked away by Greg Horry, and Mashoff comes up with it. Well, you gotta get rid of it quick. 5 minutes left, first half. Rockets lead 29-17. Mashoff right circle, right wing to Jeremy Schubert. Top of the key, Meline. Mashoff left circle, back to Meline. Meline holding the basketball. It's a screen to the left wing, now to the left baseline. Left wing to Jeremy Schubert, back to Meline in the left corner. Stegman on him now. Right circle to Mashoff, back to Meline. 4.5 minutes left. Rockets by 12. Meline, left wing to Jeremy Schubert. Back out to Meline. Right circle to Lichtenfeld, back to Meline. Right wing to Mashoff, to Lichtenfeld, right side of the lane. Shot up and good. And Okaville leads 31-17. Matt Horry appeared to be all over Ryan Lichtenfeld. May have even fouled him on the shot. He got it down. That's 6 now for Ryan Lichtenfeld. Dietrich drives the lane, bounces to Conkle. Good pass. Stop fake. Missed the layup. Ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Okaville. Conkle faked, and he got Ryan Lichtenfeld in the air. He was hoping that Lichtenfeld was going to come down on his back, but he didn't. He came across, and I think deflected the shot just a little. And I think you got a hand on it. Conkle put it off too hard. Nashville substitutes, Matt Horry out, Brandon Auld in. Stegman to inbound to Conkle. Conkle on the baseline, going to force it up. Lichtenfeld fouled it. That comes with 4 minutes to play in the third quarter. Okaville 31, Nashville 17. Well, if the Hornets want to make a move, they better start it here in the third quarter. 14-point lead, and the Hornets have still only scored 17 points in the game. The Rocket defense is tough, and the Hornets just have to hope the Rockets can cool off and they creep back into it eventually. Conkle makes the first free throw. Gradually or whatever. 31-18. Second foul of the ballgame on Ryan Lichtenfeld. 6'6", junior Josh Conkle. One more coming up. Conkle's free throw is good. Okaville leads 31-19. Meline will bring it up court. Jay Schubert picks him up. Meline bounces on the right wing. Brandon Auld reaches in, knocks it out of bounds. Not only do we have Schubert,
Schubert's and Harries. We got cousins out there. Brandon Hall, the cousin of Greg Harry. They're guarding each other. They kind of look alike, don't they? Meline has it at the right circle. Now Hall's guarding Jeremy Schubert. Pass to the right wing to Lichtenfeld. Up top to Jeremy Schubert. Right wing to Meline. Meline takes a few dribbles. Goes to Greg Harry. Left circle. Left wing to Mashoff. Back to Greg Harry. Up top Meline. 3.5 minutes left. Mashoff left wing. Meline head of the key. Dribbles to the right wing. Up top Mashoff. Back to Meline. Goes left wing to Greg Harry. 31-19 Rockets. Out to Meline at the point. Right wing Jeremy Schubert. His three-point shot is no good. Rebound Brandon Hall. And then he is knocked down by Shane Mashoff. It was just a long rebound to the corner. Everybody's momentum. Mashoff was taking his momentum was going away from the basket toward the ball, and Hall was going straight toward the baseline. He got to the ball first, and Mashoff bumped into it in his second foul. Nashville, Josh Conkle takes a breather. 6'3 junior, Terry Telchinski replaces him. The foul on Shane Mashoff was his second. 3 minutes to play, third quarter. 31-19, Oakville. Dietrich, guarded by Mashoff, stops at the left hash mark. Up top to Eric Stegman. Stegman drives the lane, stops in heavy traffic, leans in. His shot rolls out, and the ball goes off one of the Hornets. These are contested shots Nashville's putting up, but they're such close ranges. Can't get him to go down?
Those are the ones you got to make in a close ball game. Stegman's 1 out of 6 on the field. He went over the top to keep the ball alive, and I think Stegman was the one that knocked it out.
2:40 left. Third quarter.
Not actually that close a ball game, but if the Hornets want to get back in it, they got to make those shots. That's one of the reasons why they got behind. They missed that one.
Lichtenfeld hit Greg Harry. Back door. He got screened off, and it's an easy layup for Greg Harry. 33-19, Oakville. Nashville takes a timeout with 2:27 left. This is the Carlisle Regional.
Doctor's Cream really does help stop arthritis pain. Get Doctor's Cream at the Nashville Pharmacy, Route 127 South.
Nashville Hornets, for them, the pain just won't go away right now in the form of the Oakville Rockets. Oakville 33, Nashville 19, 2:27 remaining in the third quarter. 14-point lead for Oakville, and it seems a lot bigger than that. Oakville handles the ball very well, and if they're ahead by double digits, late in the ball game, you can write this one down.
Yeah, that's pretty well true. And you're right. The reason it seems such a big lead is the Hornets have so much trouble scoring. It's a low-scoring ball game. Nashville scored 5 points in this quarter, just as they did in the entire second period. Oakville scored 7, so it's been a low-scoring quarter. It's really been a low-scoring ball game, and that really is to the benefit of the Hornets. If they were going to win it, it would be a low-scoring game, but it's too low-scoring on the Hornets side of the board.
Dietrich drives past Mashoff in the lane. Good. Pass to Telchinski. Partially blocked by Greg Harry. Telchinski got a back and Lichtenfeld fouled him. And that will be the third foul on Ryan Lichtenfeld. And Telchinski to the free throw line. Oakville fans not happy about the foul against Lichtenfeld when Greg Harry may have been called for one before that. Nashville fans are getting all ready to scream about the non-call on Greg Harry. But for them, it turned out better because that's the third foul on Lichtenfeld,
I guess.
Telchinski makes the first free throw. Nobody's happy, are they? Telchinski hits both free throws. You and I, Tickle. 33-21. Oakville leads Nashville.
Well, you know, we're easy to entertain.
That's right. 2:10 left, third quarter. Meline to the right wing. Stop. Goes up top to Mashoff. Back to Meline. Picks up the dribble. Top of the key, Mashoff. Left wing, Greg Harry. 2 minutes left. Meline at the point. Left wing, Greg Harry. Back to Meline. Right wing to Jeremy Schubert. Jeremy Schubert up top to Meline. Hornets in the man-to-man. Meline to Mashoff at the right circle. To Jeremy Schubert. Cutting the lane. Gets the layup and he is fouled. Jeremy Schubert with a nice cut into the lane.
Yeah, got a pick down low on a low block. Got around the lane. Had a little bit of a head start and a nice drive to the basket. The foul. Telchinski coming over to help out. Got his first. It was a good play by the Rockets.
6'1 senior Matt Harry replaces Brandon Auld in the Hornet lineup. 1:46
34, left third period. And Jeremy Schubert at the strike. His free throw is good. Oakerville leads 36-21. And at this point in the game, the Hornets just don't have the overall team quickness to come out and put a lot of pressure on and trap. If they do, it's going to be backdoor city. Stiegler has it right wing to Hari, right circle. Picks up his dribble, hands to Chad Dietrich. Minute 30. Dietrich backdoors it for Stiegman. Pass too tall. Can't save it out of bounds. Wasn't a bad idea. Pass just a little long. Turnover number 10 against the Hornets in the ballgame. 36-21. Oakerville leads. Brian Melein lets the coach lick the foul and gets his instructions. Minute 15 left. Melein throws right wing to Jeremy Schubert. Dribbles it out to the point. All the way to the left wing, 70 seconds. Now Jeremy Schubert dribbles back to the right wing. To Greg Hari, back to Jeremy Schubert. Dribbles into the lane area and it falls down. We've got a whistle and a foul. Matt Hari and Jeremy Schubert both hitting the deck, and it's Matt Hari that gets the foul. 1 minute remaining, third period. Oakerville leads 36-21. Brandon Aul back into the Nashville lineup. He replaces Jay Schubert. The foul on Matt Hari was his first. And the Rockets will trigger from under their own hoop. And Jeremy Schubert will do so. Goes right wing to Melein. Up top, Mashon. Back to Melein. Melein backs it out. Up top, Mashon. Melein. The Rockets going for the last shot, leading by 15 with 45 seconds to play, third quarter. Jeremy Schubert has it at the point. Behind the right side to Mashaw. He dribbles to the point, goes to Melein. Behind the right side to Jeremy Schubert. Jeremy Schubert on the dribble to the point. Goes back to Melein. Left circle. Behind the left side to Mashaw, 25 seconds left. Jeremy Schubert at the right hash mark. 20 seconds. He dribbles to the point. To Mashon at the right hash mark. 15 seconds. Melein near the timeline at the middle of the insignia. Carlisle Indians. 10 seconds left. Melein goes right wing to Mashon. To Lichtenfeld post below. Here comes the shot. Baseliner missed. Rebound Matt Hari, and that will end the third quarter as Hari flings it length of the court and onto the stage. Kid's got a good arm. Maybe he should be a baseball pitcher. He may be soon if the Hornets don't rally. At the end of three quarters, it's Oakerville.
Can you get it plugged into your battery?
Suffer injuries or your family encounters illness, you know you can count on the Family Medical Center to do their best to serve you. For an appointment in Nashville, call 327-8216. In Oakville, 243-6447. Again, best wishes for local athletes from Drs. Thomas Coy, Ralph Kelly, and Gary Goforth, and the nurses and office personnel of the Family Medical Center.
Hornets gets the ball first to start the fourth quarter. And White moving right to left. Oakerville leads 36-21. Chad Dietrich drives the lane. 10-footer off the side of the backcourt. No good. Just to the left of the rim. Rebound Lichtenfeld of Oakerville. Mashaw, Melein, Jeremy Schubert, Greg Hari, and Lichtenfeld for the Rockets in blue moving left to right. Chad Hoffman, a 5'10 junior in the game for Nashville, guarding Melein. He's got the ball at the point. Melein drives the lane, and Chad Hoffman pushed off against him. Chad Hoffman just trying to keep up with Melein. The Hornets inserted Hoffman in the lineup to hopefully put a little more pressure on the Rocket guards and with some fresh legs. But, Nashville coach Darren Lee gets a technical. The official Jim Padberg gives it to Darren, who walked about 10 to 12 feet onto the court to make sure that he got the D. Hornets right now going with Hoffman and Dietrich, Matt Hari, Stiegman, and Hoffman got the foul, and Melein will be shooting a one-on-one first. That puts the Rockets in the bonus, and then the two-shot technical. So this could be four free throws and the possession for the Rockets. So
So Meline is a strike. 36-21, Oakville leads. 37-21. The Rockets could have a 19-point lead in the ball within seconds. Meline hits both free throws. And now Ryan Lichtenfeld will shoot the technical shot. And Darren Lee walks out into the court again, and he wants Fatberg to come over to the scorer's bench. Oakville 38, Nashville 21. Rocket coach Dave Lichtenfeld isn't going to let Darren get all the jawing in. He walks over to the scorer's bench to see what's going on. 7:35 left in the ballgame as the Oakville Rockets on the verge of blowing out the Nashville club. 17-point lead right now. If indeed Oakville was in the bonus. Now Jim Patberg draws both coaches together to explain the situation to them. Maybe Oakville was... What's your stats? Oakville on the bonus?
No, I do only have 16 fouls marked down against the Hornets. That includes the first one. They've got Hoffman for two fouls on the board.
But that's not accurate. He just went in the game.
See what happens. I think the technical foul against the coach...
Oh, goes to that player.
Goes toward it. Well, not the player. Goes toward a... I'm not sure if that goes toward a team foul or not. Anyway, they shot two free throws.
They won't count, though.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. See, they have wiped them off the board. Ryan Lichtenfeld will shoot two technical shots. He makes them both.
All right.
So Meline's two free throws never happened. Forget
all right.
it.
I believe you.
Oakville was not in the bonus at that point, but they are now. Oakville 38, Nashville 21, 7:35 left.
Right. A technical on a coach does not go toward the total team foul. The technical on a player does, as it goes against the player as a personal foul.
Well, there, you've explained it. Meline, guarded by Chad Hoffman, knocks the ball loose. Hoffman steals it. Dribbles to the right wing. Now the right corner. Gives to Matt Horry. Down low. Good pass to Hall. Missed the layup. Got it back. Fake shot up. No good, but he was fouled again. And the Hornets just cannot put the ball in the hoop.
No, they can't. But really, the Hornets just needed something to get fired up about. That was it. They got a technical. And not necessarily that was it. But Hoffman got a steal. And they just got to get some lives in this fourth quarter if they want to come back.
I think it was very smart of Darren Lee to do it.
I think it's,
you never know.
It's a big hill to climb.
Well, it was
a big hill before anyway.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah. What do you got to lose? All misses the first free throw. 7:13 remaining. Oakville 38, Nashville 21. The foul was on Greg Horry, his second. All makes the second free throw. And it's 38-22. Lichtenfeld goes at length of the court and grabbed by Mashoff, drives into the lane, hits the shot, he's fouled. Hornets put some pressure on in midcourt. The Oakville alley-ooped it back door, and Mashoff, or rather Meline, was there to grab it. I think I said Mashoff before. That was Meline that put it in, and he was fouled.
And he did a heck of a job of catching that ball. If it was football, you would say the defender, Brandon Ald, was in perfect position, which he seemed to be, but Meline came down with it. Got the shot in, all third foul.
40-22, Oakville. Meline's free throw is good. 41-22, Oakville. 7 minutes left in the game. And the Rockets are blowing the Hornets out. Diedrich guarded by Mashoff. Bounces right wing to Hall. Hall guarded by his cousin Greg Horry. Bounces up top to Eric Stegall. Guarded by Jeremy Schubert. Mashoff reaches in and fouls him, knocking the ball away. 55 left in this one, and the Rockets lead by 19. Hoffman, Diedrich, Ald, Horry, Matt Horry, and Stegman at the line for the Hornets right now.
Eric Stegman is still setting on 3 points, Bo, and you mentioned the matchup before the game started. Lichtenfeld on Stegman. Stegman didn't have a good night scoring at Oakville, but nobody did, and again, he's had a tough going tonight.
Missed the free throw. Brandon Ald, the rebound. Throws back out. It's batted by Meline to Diedrich. Left wing, Chad Hoffman. Three-pointer is good. Chad Hoffman played well off the bench. Nashville pressing. Nobody guarding Greg Horry at the other end. Lichtenfeld throws it length of the court for an easy layup. Everybody for Nashville was pressing, and nobody guarded the goal. Nashville pulled their goalie, and it was an open slap shot for the Rockets. Oakville 43, Nashville 25, with 6:34 left, and this is the Carlisle Regional.
Woody, he's the guy to see for all your passenger car and light truck mechanical repairs. Woody's Automotive Service in Nashville offers major and minor repair work, including complete brake service, oil changes, and car washing. Just call 327-3140. Open 7:30 in the morning till 7 at night, Monday through Friday, 7:30 till 6 on Saturday. Woody's Automotive Service Center, 301 West St. Louis Street in Nashville.
So Greg Harre gets the open net goal with 6:34 remaining in the ballgame. And it's Oakville, 43, Nashville 25. And when the Hornets are behind, it's been this way all season. They're 20-7 this year. But when they get behind, they just have a heck of a time catching up.
The only game I remember where they really came back from behind and made a game of it was against Murfreesboro. They ended up losing the ballgame. That's the last Harre goal of 1:26 in the fourth quarter with 6:34 to play in the ballgame. And obviously with an 18-point lead,
shoot two. Guys, the basket, free throw is good. That
Jeremy Schubert. 3.5 minutes remaining. 50 to 34, Oakenville leads Nashville. Nashville with the left hash mark, fouled by Chad Peter. And back to the stripe we go. Where it ends, nobody knows. 6th-grade junior Terry Palchinski replaces Brandon Auld in the Nashville lineup. Diedrich was his third. And Mashoff gets a 1-1. Free throw is good. 51-34, Oakville. The Rocket fans, by the way, cheering all that much. It's such a big lead that nobody's using up much energy. Here's the statement into the section. Mashoff hit them both, 52-34, Oakville. 3.20 remaining. Chad Diedrich dribbling up the point. Wing of Palchinski. Put the bell on him. Up top to Stegman. Stegman from 17 feet. Banked it, didn't get it. Rebound, Lichtenfeld. Here's the Mashoff. Mashoff in the front court right side. 3 minutes remaining. The Rockets lead by 18. Mashoff. Guarded by Dieter. Goes high to left side to Jeremy Schubert. Jay Schubert on him. The Mashoff, left hash mark.
Come on.
Doc's got a suggestion for you that just might make this payday even better. Okay, you ready? Take your paycheck and open a Magna Welcome account with free checks, savings account, plus free unlimited checking for 6 months. Why? To get you to compare Magna to your bank. Now, since this is free and your bank probably isn't, why not go ahead and try Magna? Then after 6 months, if you don't love them, then you can leave them. See you on payday. Magna Bank, member FDIC. Doring Pharmacy in Nashville offers a wide selection of healthcare items in their expanded store. Low pricing, too. Check the Nashville News for special sale items. Doring Pharmacy is conveniently located within walking distance in downtown Nashville.
Sessions of Essential will go on sale Monday morning at Nashville High.
did not score tonight, 0-3 from the field. All those shot attempts in the first half. Matt Radetsky also saw action, didn't score. For the Hornets, Nashville was 11 of 33 from three-point range, 33%, 3 of 8 from three-point range for 37.5% for the Hornets, 14 of 41 from the field. 34% shooting for the ball game, 10 of 17 for the charity stripe, 59% there. The Hornets actually had one more rebound than Oakville. That's counting that last one possession. He got it because they went on 25-24. The rebounding was just quite one in Nashville. The Hornets led 9-6 after one quarter, but therein lies the story, really. It could have been 9-3 at the end of the period. That Nashville with Shane Maxwell buried a long three-pointer at the end of the first period. Nashville led by 3 after one. The second period was a big downfall for the Hornets. Oakville scored 20 points in Nashville, 5, and the Rockets led 26-14 at the half. Oakville outscored Nashville 10-7 in period 3, and the Rockets had a 15-point lead, 36-21 as we went to the fourth quarter. The Rockets again outscoring Nashville in period 4, 24-20 for the final score. Oakville 60, Nashville 41. Turnovers, Nashville had 12, the Rockets had 10 in the ballgame. Nashville coach Darren Lee is alongside there. Condolences on the ballgame. They play awful well. We look good under the basketball team. Were there any particular turning points in the ballgame, you think? How about that shot at the end of the first quarter by Shane Mashaw?
Yeah, I thought that was a big one. I think it gave him a lot of confidence that he'd come out and hit a few more. We should have got up on him, cut our ball fairly. But, you know, we don't expect him to hit one from the top 40 too many times. So, I don't know, we can't hardly say much to the kids. I just thought the coach should have got on him, but...
Yeah, Oakville did a lot of the things you knew they were going to do in terms of the quickness and everything. It just couldn't stop it, did it?
Nope. We just can't. We had them posted early, and for some reason we just can't turn. You know, we just can't find it. And at least they're quick with this gift of thoughts, and we just have a whole lot of trouble. You know, we tried to go inside out, and we just can't get it done. Couldn't get it done enough, and obviously we're quick to turn.
You had your fingers crossed hoping that the guard, Milan Mashoff, would be unable to get the shot from outside, but they wound up doing it.
The coach's wife. Yay, Florida! Keeps that boy on his toes. Keeps him healthy.
Look at me. How worth it?
Worth less.
Yeah.
Four number one.
In the cup!
Congratulations! went upside down.
Take me with the fork. We won. Keep in the hole.
Shane.
speech going. Make him say speech.
My holiday.
on for me. It's been one of, certainly was interrupted for a while, and it's been a super, I can't think of a year I've had more fun. No question about it. And a big part of that, a big part of this team, and I think the team knows it, is Coach Smith. Coach Smith.
Yeah!